go.
There you go.
We're going to turn this thing into the Tonight Show before the year's out. At least I am. I don't know how long I'll last, but I think you open with the monologue. Paul Shaver have a little band over here. You have guests.
Yeah. He can be like Ed McMahon.
From Studio A in San Francisco, brought to you by Amici's Pizza, it's Giants pregame late night with Ahmed Fareed. Joined by the One Flan Band, with special guests Alex Pavlovich, Crook and Kike, Amy G, and Sean Estes. Now your host, Ahmed Fareed!
Oh, you guys are too kind. You are too kind. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Grant, up there. Appreciate that. Flan, Tim Flannery, the one and only one-man Flan in Giants pregame. Hey, over there, Flan.
Hey, Ahmed. Great to see you.
How's it going? Big night. You know, we got a big night. There's a lot going on today. Giants back at home. Happy to be back home. 20 of their next 26 games will be on the shores of McCovey Cove. They're 19-11 right here at home. That's the fifth best record in all of Major League Baseball. One person, Flan, happy about that's Bruce Bochy. Seeing as he can't travel with his custom-made pillow because it won't fit in the overhead bin. He doesn't fit in the overhead bin over there. Thought that was better in the writing room. Brandon Belt, he had a home run last game. Good to see him back. Good to see him back here, back and healthy. First home run since his emergency appendectomy. So now in pursuit of the home run title, he's now considering donating his kidney as well. He just figures that the less organs he has, no one liked that. Okay, the bullpen has been lights out as of late. So much so the core four almost becoming a distant memory. Luckily, for Affelt and Javi, they found ways to remain relevant, being part of the broadcast. They're doing a great job.
Great job.
As part of the broadcast. Yeah, absolutely. But Javi also taking a job as a wiffle ball integrity tester right there. It's good. Solid ball.
Solid pitch. He made a mistake in the zone.
He missed his spot right there. I feel like if he located it better, that wouldn't have happened to him. Flan, finally, Derek Jeter's new look, Miami Marlins come to town. For the first time this season, one of the lowest payrolls in all of baseball. So low, in fact, the team can't afford a San Francisco hotel. They can't. They've been priced out of San Francisco. Flan, you were nice enough to work out an Airbnb deal with a team to stay in Half Moon Bay with you.
Well, actually, we started that. And then I talked to Don Mattingly, and they figured that maybe, because I'm a late-night musician, that the KOA campground, a little south of Half Moon Bay, is where they're all going to be camping
tonight. Yeah, that might be a better idea.
Yeah, safer.
Still not in San Francisco, but maybe it's the campground would be just a little safer. Get them away from Flan. We have a great show tonight, everyone. Giants insider Alex Pavlovich will be on the show, yes. Great insider, great information there. The best broadcast team in all of baseball, Crook and Kipe, will join us. The great Amy G will talk with the Giants' number two overall pick, Georgia Tech catcher Joey Bart. And if we have time, we're going to talk to former Giants pitcher Sean Estes. We may or may not have time to get Sean on the show today, but Flan, he may be talking about, if we have time, his man crush Monday, Andy Suarez. We'll get to that, Flan, after the break.
Was a left-hander in this town, and my curveball, it broke down, and I bled black and orange like Andrew Suarez. We're a similar kind of soul, and if there's anything you want to know about the pitches that he throws, he's my bromance. Monday Man Crush is coming on NBC here after the break. Couch, please hurry. You could be making a big mistake. Estes and Suarez, man.